Good morning, YouTube. Today I thought I'd shoot something a little bit different, get away from all of the construction and engineering videos. It's another freezing cold day here, and I got a package in the mail. I'm not going to tell you what it is yet. I'll show you as we open it. Pardon the mess here. I've got drafting tools all over the table. I'm working on some design stuff. Look familiar to anybody? yeah, that's, well, in case you're wondering, there's the drafting kit that I lugged around in college back and forth, and still had it, so I've been digging it out to make use of it. Anyway, the topic for today's video is something I ordered, and this is direct from Hongming Hao at eStorms in Shenzhen Province, Guangdong, China. This was something I saw on Amazon for, I think it was $19.99, and I'll put a link up to the page. I'll put a still photo so you can see the page, and of course it's a fake kind of thing. Normally $380 odd, if I remember correctly, but now, you know, blowout special, getting rid of them. What it is a Chinese knockoff of a product you may have seen. So let me go ahead and carefully. Wow, it's sad. This thing is kind of a fragile electronic component, and they didn't take very great care with the packaging. I kind of hoped it would come in a box, but so we get here. But it comes in a protective carry case, the eStorm's official carry case, and it's got a belt clip because you never know, you might need it for your super secret spy belt. And there's a belt loop deal. You can put it on your belt that way, so you can wear it on your Batman costume, I guess. And it is, well, I don't read Chinese, but you can see it's a pair of super secret spy sunglasses. And I don't read Chinese at all. Here we go. User manual for HD sunglasses camera. So I this is the poor man's Google Glass. So I'm a redneck glass hole, I guess you would say. For $20, I couldn't resist. This is the first HD DV sunglasses. You can shoot high definition video, taking high quality photos, recording high quality audio, supporting micro SD card. With simple operation, elegant design, small size, it is easy to carry. It is an essential utility to business, education, security, media, justice, tourism, healthcare, living, and other field. Well, that's actually better than most of the translations I've read. it's got a camera basically in the nose bridge. And what do they have here? On-off switch, the mode button, there's a LED indicator, there's a microphone, mini 5-pin USB, and then the micro SD slot. Now, I think this thing is supposed to talk to Windows. I don't use Windows unless someone basically pays me to. But if it shoots, let's see, what video formats are AVI, encoding is MJPEG. Supposedly, this thing will record up to 1280 by 720. I don't know if I buy off on that for $20, but we'll see. Like I said, picture pixels is 1600 by 1200 or 2560 by 1440. However, the ratio of the image is 4 to 3. How does that work? Well, we put in the black borders, and it's actually a 240 by 4, you know, 320 by 240 in the middle of all this blackness, is what I'm willing to bet. But they support Windows ME, 2000, XP, 2003, and Vista. Mac OS 10.4. Uncertainty depends on the computer model, Linux. Oh. Given that it dumps AVIs and probably JPEGs, I can read them off the SD card on my Linux box. No big deal. so there are the instructions. I'll go through it later, but let's take a look at what you get. You get a little mini USB plug. You get a cleaning cloth because, you know, and you get the glasses. I guess I can't complain about how it was packed for $20. Boy, look at these trendy little monkeys. Boy. All right, I'm going to put these on very briefly and see if the lens quality is any good whatsoever. because I'd read some reviews on this after I'd ordered it. People were complaining about how swimmy the lenses were. Actually, these are quite good. The other complaint I'd read, there are several. The camera is aimed too high, so you have to bear that in mind, supposedly. We'll see after I test them. The microphone picks up nothing but wind noise, unless you're inside. You can't tell what mode you're in. But I saw also a couple of reviews where people were saying, no, you just got to read the instructions and pay attention to the blinks. Apparently it uses like blink codes or something. The construction quality, I think it's a somewhat fragile plastic. These aren't flexible. This is all hard plastic. It feels almost like the old Bakelite, but I know it's not. It's a thermoplastic. I'll have to see where the battery compartment goes. I think that plug right there is a filler for the SD slot. I'm going to have to figure out how to get that out. And I think the batteries go on this side, maybe? I'm not sure. I've got to go get an SD card, and then I will try this and shoot some video. But I wanted you to see the unboxing. for 20 bucks, you're certainly not going to be stealthy in these things. It looks like you've got a hearing aid in each ear. Or, you know, you've got a field blocking device to keep the aliens from reading your brainwaves. I don't know. But I'm going to go ahead and go get an SD card and see if I need to get like a coin cell battery for this or what all is required. And I will be back with part two. But there you go. So far, I'd say it's worth the 20 bucks. You know, if it works halfway, just to have fun playing with, that would be neat. And the lenses actually do work. They're not swimmy. They're not all boogered up. They're pretty decent quality. So this would be something where if I was doing some of the woodworking videos, especially if I'm shooting outside in the sun, I can see using this to kind of augment what I'm doing with the regular camera. Give a POV as I'm building stuff and assembling. But we'll see. Okay, I had a quick read of the instructions while sipping my coffee. And you actually, you recharge the battery through the USB. And it says the English is a little bit broken, but for the first five times. Activate the battery maximum. Yeah, let me try this again. The battery is with no memory effect. It can be used and charged at any time, but for the initial five times of charging, please charge battery to saturation after the battery runs out. It is to activate the battery maximum capacity and maintain the working time. In order to maximize the capacity of storage battery, please continue to charge for 30 minutes to 1 hour after the indicator light long bright. So basically, let it sit and on a full charge on the charger for the first couple of times. And I was wrong. It also comes with an SD card pre-installed. And the mechanism actually works pretty good. That is a 2 gig stick, which is not going to be much if it actually is recording at 1280 by 720, but we'll see. so I'm going to go ahead and put these on the charger and let them charge off my laptop, I think, while I go and do some other stuff. But yeah, actually, it came with a 2 gig SD card. I don't know what the limit is. There was nothing I saw in the instructions about can it take a bigger one. I'd like to put in an 8 gig if it can take it, if it's actually recording in HD. If it's not, then 2 gigs should be sufficient. So so far I'm actually kind of impressed. So let me charge it and then I'll come back. Okay, sorry for the poor lighting, but we're upstairs in my office and I have plugged the sunglasses into my laptop while I eat my lunch and do some other things. And let's see if you can see this on the camera. Right there on the stem of the glasses is a tiny, it's actually very, very small, but very bright LED. And it's doing a slow blink, which I assume means it is charging. And based on the broken English and the instructions, I can only presume that that will go to a solid red when it believes that the lithium-ion battery is fully charged. Once that's the case, I'll just leave it on there for an extra hour or two for this initial charging, and then we'll try it out. But The USB cable fits in there pretty well. It's not a high quality cable, but it doesn't need to be really. It's only drawing maybe 100 or 150 milliamps to do the charging on this cell. There is a little bit of warmth right around here in the case. I can barely tell, but clearly that's where the battery is charging. But so far, the stems seem a little bit fragile and the hinges seem a little bit fragile. But again, for $20 overall, this is pretty amazing technology. We'll see what it's like when it records. But I just plugged it in and I'm going to let it charge. And so far, it seems pretty straightforward. Knowing that a lot of people don't read instructions, don't really understand how technology works, I'm not surprised that some people have problems with it. But we'll see how it goes. Like I said, I'm not expecting much for $20, but so far I have been pleasantly surprised. I think these could be a fun thing to mess around with. Okay, the glasses have been sitting on the USB charger for a little over an hour. And just a few minutes ago I looked over and noticed that the light had gone solid. So, according to the instructions, on the first 5 charges, you let it sit for 30 minutes to an hour. So, I'm going to go do some stuff, work on some projects in the garage, and I'm going to let these continue to charge, and then I will monkey with them a little bit more tonight. Just dawned on me, I don't have an adapter that will take a micro SD. So, I'm going to have to go buy a micro SD card anyway just to get the adapter to get any video data off of this. I may try to pull directly from USB initially, but the transfer rate's going to be a lot slower than the SD card slot. So, but yeah, according so far, everything's pretty good. And it's, like I said, it's gotten a little bit warm, but really not even noticeable. So we'll let that sit and we'll be back. Okay, I'm recording this in hopes that it comes out well. Just as a lark, I decided to go ahead and try to connect the sunglasses and see what happens, see if it shows up here on my Linux laptop. Right now this is a program called USB View, and it shows the dynamic configuration of the system and everything that's connected to whichever controllers it happens to be patched into. I'm going to go ahead and plug in the glasses here, and you should see it show up here on the EHCI host controller. Okay, I plug it in. Wait a second, and click on refresh. And go away, KDE, you're annoying. Okay, it shows up as a generic USB mass storage device. So it's got USB 2.0. 480 megabit per second, and right, that seems to be working here. All right, so it's being picked up. Now the question is, shrink this down, background that. And if I SDB1. Oh, it's showing up as SDC1. Alright, so let's try something here. I think I have EXT drive defined. Yeah. Mount type auto dev SDC1 and mount that onto external drive. Mount SDC1 type VFAT. Alright. Photo, record, video. All right. That's good. It's not recording anything. And it's showing up as a 2 gig stick. So I do have a way to get the data off of the sunglasses, which is good.
That'll save me having to buy a little adapter for the micro SD to regular SD to be able to read it. Now again, the speed may be a little bit slow, but it'll be cool to experiment with. So for any of you who might be using Linux, yes, it actually does work. Yes, it shows up, and it should show up as just a generic mass storage device, and it was a VFAT partition. Highlight it right there. If you've got your kernel configured correctly. Anybody else using Mac and Windows, it probably just auto-recognizes and will show up as like a USB thumb drive for what you're used to. So far so good. I'm pretty impressed with this. We'll see how well how good the video is. I'm going to play with that here in a minute. Hey, it's me again. Okay, I've been playing with the glasses just a little bit, and what I found is it's taken a picture. I haven't tried the video yet, but let me give you a quick look at the picture quality. It recommends high lumen light. It's not a low light camera. It actually recorded a 1600 by 1200 photo. I think it's interpolating a bit. I don't think that's an honest resolution. Excuse me. You'll note it timestamps everything, which I'm going to show in a second how you fix that. But my office is actually pretty dark right now. So the only light was coming from my desk lamp and the screen of the laptop. And as you can see, it was passable. And I think I was moving my head around when I took the picture. I'm going to edit the file called time.txt that shows up in the root directory of the USB drive that the glasses show up as. And according to the directions, I can modify this, and it will allow me to set that timestamp that shows up on the overlay. So let me see. Today is the 6th of February, and right now it's around, say, 1654. Okay, it says when I boot the glasses again, and yes, it says there's a boot sequence, that will show up. But let me unmount the device, and we'll try to shoot a little bit of video here. Okay, it looks like the glasses are working exactly according to the instructions. If you read the instructions, even with the stilted English, the red and blue LED indicators with their blink sequences and so on, it works precisely. You can put it in photo mode, you can put it in video mode. Let me get into my directory here. Super duper spy glasses. Okay, I showed you one picture already. I'm going to go ahead and show you a test movie that I took, and I'm not going to speak in this. I don't know if you'll be able to hear the playback on it or not, but it actually does work. Now, I was in here in my office, and it's a very short video, but it'll give you some idea of the quality.
Okay, supposedly right now, I'm putting the glasses on. I'm recording video. All right, for the record, glasses are centered on my face, and I am staring at the center of the screen. We'll see how this camera records, whether it's angled up or down improperly according to the reviews. I can always learn to perch these further down on my nose. But I'm going to go ahead and do a slow pan around the office here and see how well they record. This is admittedly a low light setting, and I don't know what this is going to look like. It said it was a wide angle lens. Not sure about that.
All right, we're going to stop the recording now.
Okay, as you saw, it actually was picking stuff up. Based on what my eye line was while I was recording, I can tell you that the camera is recording high and to the right slightly of where my actual center eyeball focus was. Now, my head is not perfectly symmetrical, but I am not that misshapen, I don't think. Dear God, I hope not. So I have to perch them down a little bit further on my nose and remember that they're going to be off to the right by about 5 or 8 degrees, somewhere in there. I haven't worked this out exactly. I'm now going to show you a couple more of the pictures that I took that looking out the window. I opened up the blinds and it actually took decent picture. As before though, this is recording at 1600 by 1200 supposedly, but if you look, there's a lot of artifacting and pixelation. So if I shrink it down, I think it's actually closer in terms of native pixel quality to something that's about 800 by 600, maybe 1024 by 768. But it's picking up the new timestamp correctly, you can see, that I put into the time.txt file. And I have another photo here. I took another one out the window. And it was pretty much the same view, but in this one, I was staring, my field of view was dead center on this red thingy in the neighbor's yard. So you can see the camera center is definitely high and to the right by a bit. Now, the further away you're looking, the less of a problem it is, but it's something to bear in mind. And given that I'm a Linux geek, I went ahead and created a file to go ahead and update the time automatically. So after I've offloaded pictures, I basically call this little script that I wrote, and it will update that time.txt file with whatever the current system clock is. But as you saw, it actually worked, and the audio was not horrible. So in terms of a $20 expenditure, absolutely. It's now really just a question of how well the batteries hold up and how well they handle being worn and taken off and so on. I'm going to be careful with them, but I'm going to go ahead and try to use these in the garage on some of these shop projects. I would definitely say it's worth the $20.